During the launch, Sam Kizara, the Deputy Commissioner of Museums and Monuments Department, who represented Doreen Katusime, the Permanent Secretary of the Ministry of Tourism, Wildlife and Antiquities, said the Raleigh Museum will not only build the tourism base, but also as a means of preserving the history and heritage of this country.
The Uganda Raleigh Museum has come at a time when most of the original Raleigh hardware has been vandalized. Most of the rail line, particularly the Busoga line and its sleepers, were stolen and imported later and into scrap for recycling.
The chairperson of the Uganda Tourism Board, Daudi Migereko, said with the Raleigh Museum in place, businesses of local people will prevail. Migereko appealed to Uganda Raleigh Corporation to consider taking advantage of local raw materials from local companies as they revitalize the Raleigh.
Opening up the museum at a very strategic moment, I want to make an appeal to you, Chairman. As you revitalize the library, as you reconstruct the 1 meter gauge library, let's take advantage of the local raw materials. This man is in trouble. He became mayor because he was talking so much about government the other way. He did not know that the unemployed would become his problem.
The head of European Union delegation in Uganda, Pacific Antillio, who was represented at the launch by Caroline Andriensen, the head of cooperation, noted that the museum presents a great opportunity to reorganize and appreciate the history of Raleighs in Uganda. Antillio said the European Union is delighted to support the revival of this crucial infrastructure and an important piece of their collective memory in Uganda.
We found it was very important as we are both looking ahead in how to develop the railway for the future, also look back at the history of railway here in Uganda by trying to give a testimony of the importance of railway as a contribution to regions and sub-regions and making the link between several regions and even countries. We have seen the efforts that Ugandan Tourism Board and the Ministry of Tourism have put in rebranding Uganda, Explore Uganda, the new brand, inviting visitors to explore Uganda beyond the maybe obvious routes. I think this is indeed another testimony of Uganda's heritage, and it can be an additional asset, as a colleague from UTB, the Honorable, has mentioned already, and is definitely something we will also be continue working on in our work together with the government of Uganda, looking how we can further support the tourism sector for Jinja, but also many other regions in Uganda.
The Minister for Tourism in Busoga Kingdom, Helen Namutamba, outlined the beauties and outstanding tourism sites in Busoga.
Busoga has the most outstanding tourism sites. If you talk about culture, we have them all. We are the only, tribe in Uganda that appreciates and celebrates and recognizes every year our first settlement when we migrated, when we came from Bunyoro along Lake Choga to Kaburu Rock. We climb every year. It's a heritage site.
So a testament of that contribution and Jinja having been, and I'm sure it's going to be again, the industrial heart of Uganda. So we are very happy to be here, and we will do everything we can as a board to support this museum.
I want to thank government of Uganda once again for reviving the rail. Because the sense of bringing back the rail, it is one way that we are going to save as government. Because you know the cost of constructing a road. These roads are too expensive, and the tonnage that is being carried on those roads, in a few years, they die out. But when you have this rail functional, all these heavy trucks and the heavy tonnage will be carried by the rail.
Story by Donald Kiria for the news.